In true American fascism, fashion, a militia called Defend Our Border Laredo is calling on people to get together, get their guns, and go and patrol the border between Mexico and the United States with the specific purpose of stopping drug cartels and illegal immigrants from crossing the border. They have specifically called on groups to come in and voluntarily defend private property. In addition to that, they've also declared their intention to kill police officers who try to stop them. The group's leader, calling himself Commander Chris 3%er Davis, has cautioned against people using any racial slurs or threats of violence while doing these patrols. Denise Freeman, a spokesperson of the group, said, "This is not a go in and guns blazing kind of thing. This will be handled with the utmost professionalism and security and safety for everyone involved." In reality, the leader actually did call for the killing of illegal immigrants. Now, this statement was made in a video that was posted on YouTube, but since the media has gotten a hold of the situation and started reporting on it, the channel has been closed. You see an illegal, you point your gun dead at him, right between the eyes, and you say, "Get back across the border or you will be shot." He also called on militia members to fire on police officers should they come to investigate what they're doing. He said, "If they do come, begin 1776 on the border right then and there," which means he's declaring his intention. If the police go in to just merely look at the situation, they are going to fire on them. Or at least he's saying to people to fire on the police if they do that. This is his bio according to his Twitter account. "I believe in the King James Bible, the Constitution, and Bill of Rights. I am a future veteran of the refounding. Molon Labe, 3% spirit of 1776. So let me get this straight. The plan here is to kill illegal immigrants, then possibly kill police officers and overthrow the government. Is that about it? Could you imagine what would happen if a leftist group said something like this? Say, like, a really radical left-wing organization took out guns and said they were going to kill the police if they were approached by them. What do you think would happen? They'd be sent in, people would be gunned down, and that would be it. But somehow these right-wing groups always seem to get away with saying stuff like this. Take the Clive and Bundy ranch. Look, they had all these armed people ready to kill government agents at any moment, and they practically terrorized the town that they were staying in, or the one that was there that the police were staying in. And they just get away with this. But you know what would happen to a leftist if this happened. But why? The issue, I believe, comes down to private property. This guy's called on people to voluntarily protect private property. Clive and Bundy is arguing, "This is my property. I can do whatever I want." Never mind the falsity of it, the fact that it's native land, all the other stuff. In his mind, and at least in the eyes of the government from a legal standpoint, it's about ownership of property. And that's what the difference is here. I mean, let's never mind that clearly these people do not understand what it is that causes illegal immigration. I mean, there's the entire social and economic structure that leads to the situations like this. The United States is the empire that has a huge hand in forcing that poverty on those people that makes them want to leave the country to begin with. But they don't see that. They don't understand a damn thing about economics. They only see brown people coming into their country. And that is the big threat. An illegal immigrant coming into the United States looking for a job to work is a terrible threat. Yet some clearly right-wing nut job with a gun threatening to kill the government and threatening to kill illegal immigrants is not bad? Now let's bring this back a bit to what this is really all about, or what he's really doing here, even if he doesn't even realize it. He is defending the system that caused all of this. That pure 1776 capitalism, and I'm sure if you asked him, he would defend capitalism as a system. It's what created all these conditions. That is what created the huge wealth gap between Mexico and the United States. Hell, that's what created the United States on Mexican land. So when he's going on screaming about illegal immigrants coming into his country, taking his jobs, think about what he's saying here. This is my first world privilege, and you don't belong here. 1776, that system that created all this. When he's saying that, he's defending, enforcing his first world privilege. When there's some joke, but racism and white supremacy built up with it. But that's essentially what he's doing. You are not allowed to come in here and take our jobs and our wealth and our land. This is the true mentality of the white colonizer. They steal everything. And when they don't feel the system that's supposed to protect that is doing enough to help them over them, they want to take it in their own hands. This is my country. This is my wealth. This is my geographical affiliation that we created. You are not allowed in here. And that's exactly what this is about. This isn't just plain racism or even just plain stupidity. This is about defending a very serious first world privilege, maintaining their situation on the backs of others. And that's a point that is going to be missed by the mainstream media, who in general denies the exploitation of the third world by the first. Thank you for watching. Please comment and rate the video. If you liked it, hit subscribe or check out some of these other great videos. If you wish, share it on social media. And while you're at it, why don't you follow me on Twitter? And if you got time, go on over to the MRN bookstore and check out some of the latest books available.